You know what I was, you're talking about, like, when the worst kind of music. What I think, you know when, like, you get, like, an old band from the 60s, and then, you know, the front man is dead, so they get a new front man. Like, the Doors did that a couple years ago.
They all did.
They had Ian Astbury, I think, lead it. And now Judas Priest or somebody is coming out, and they have a new front man or somebody.
They all eventually get around to it. Well, even, like, In Excess and not In Excess band, too. But they do that.
I think that when they do that, to be allowed to get a new front man, first they have to do an entire tour with Fred Schneider from the B-52s as their front man. Let me sleep all night in your soul kitchen.
I felt... I'm with you, by the way, because I would definitely go see that.
Riders on the Storm!
I said
the exact same, well, not the exact same thing, but I had almost the exact idea about the Sopranos when they were, going. I talked to everyone from the Sopranos pretty much through the radio show, and I said, look, would you have gone for an 8th season or a 9th season or whatever it was? And they all would have, but, you know, Tony Soprano didn't want to do a 9th season. So you have cast, crew, you literally have 200 people signed up, and what's his name?
Gandolfini
says, no, show over. I said I would have watched the entire thing with, Ted McGinley. I said they should do a 9th season. It's Ted McGinley. There's no discussion of it. There's no, like, not even one of the guys going, Tony, you lost weight. You know, just nothing. It's just nothing. He doesn't even try to do a Soprano. It's just, but it's the same dialogue. Like, here's the deal. If you're writing scripts for the Sopranos, keep writing. Do it exactly.
Go, go, go.
Everyone who's acting it, everyone who's shooting it, everyone who's doing it, you do it exactly the same as season 8 and every season before it. Don't anyone change. It's just going to be Ted McGinley who's going to be in this. And that'll be it. It'll be a bizarre, surreal, artistic experiment. And by the way, people will go like, oh, that'll be horrible. I go, I guarantee people would watch. They'd at least watch the first episode. Just one fucking episode with that guy. And again, the point is nobody can say anything about who's this new guy or what. Why is your hair blonde?
This is Angie. She's my Gumar.
Right. Yeah. That would be it. However he read it, the script's exactly the same. I would watch that.
You are a good earner.
Yes. It would be awesome. I would watch that, and I would also watch Fred from the B-52s front. For whatever band, Scorpios.
Scorpions they could do
be,
with Fred.
Would be good. Yeah, I mean, there'd be every band.
What's the Scorpions' big hit?
Guar would
Rocky
be awesome.
Like a hurricane.
Yeah.
Oh, that's almost sounds like it'd be a few. Rock you like a hurricane! Yeah. Here comes the hurricane!
Yeah, especially, he does start with a Here I Am, which is, would be awesome.
That's right.
Yeah. You gotta do
here
it.
Here I am, I'm gonna rock you like a hurricane! Yeah. Batten down the windows!
Yeah, he would throw something in. Oh, there goes a cow! He could do it just like Rock Lobster, all the stuff that was in Airborne. Look out for that windmill.
Everyone, baby, windmill, hurricane.
Everyone to the root cellar.
We're going to have some roots.
Yeah, right. You just keep, we'd make it do a 9-minute song. Everything that was ever in there, do a couple of good Wizard of Oz, riffs.
But what I love about Fred Schneider is that he is 100% Fred Schneider.
I don't think I've talked to him.
I've never met the man, but you can just, he knows exactly who he is.
Yes.
Like Adam West.
Yeah, yes.
I'm not comparing the two men.
No, Shatner, Fred, and Adam West are all doing great impersonations of themselves.
Yes. They have made a career.
I'm going to add Hasselhoff to that list of guys who do versions of that.
Yes, and I would add, again, a friend of mine in a complimentary way, Kathy Griffin. Kathy Griffin's job is being Kathy Griffin.
Right.
Fred Schneider's job is being Fred Schneider.
Yes. It's so funny. I saw Hasselhoff at a car show about 3 years ago, and there he was. You know, I was 100 yards away from the guy, and I said, Jesus, that guy looks like Hasselhoff. And then I thought, well, it can't be Hasselhoff because this guy's doing a Hasselhoff, you know, shirt undone to the navel, mm-hmm. you know, standing on the other side of the velvet rope in front of the Bugatti, leaning against the hood, wearing the boots and the big hair and stuff. And it's like, okay, this guy looks like when you hire a Howard Stern impersonator to come to your party for kicks. It's too much. It's too big. That's the whole thing about, like, it's like the guys who do the Mike Tyson impersonations sound too much. They're over the top cartoon version of.
Right.
Hasselhoff? No.
100% Hasselhoff.
He's 100% Hasselhoff all the time.
Yeah, when we had Don Knotts on The Simpsons, we had to. I ended up doing the voice because he didn't really sound like Don Knotts.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Did he sound too old?
He just didn't. He was like, well,
do
you know.
Don Knotts rock you like a hurricane?
Well, here I am. Rock you like a hurricane. Now, there's a hurricane coming. The hurricane is going to rock you. All right, now, here's the deal. I, being the hurricane, will be the thing that rocks you.
Right.
You're right.
I love Fred.